Next, we're going to think about how to infer the latent state distribution from the data. This is where we use the Kalman filter. If we are given a data set, we typically do not know about the latent state trajectory, since it is per definition hidden. We instead need to infer it directly from the data. For instance, take a recording from a population of neurons. We do not know what they're coding for, but want to infer it from their activity. This process is called inference and has a nice solution formalized by the Kalman filter for the linear dynamical system. When we do inference, we expect that our parameters summarized by theta are simply given or known. We do not worry about them yet. The inference can be done in two steps. First, the filtering, where we estimate the latent online, so to say, so as data comes in. We're working forward in time, basically every time we get a new data point, we're estimating the corresponding latent distribution there. Smoothing is the second step, and it's a little bit less intuitive, because here we estimate the latent given the whole data sequence, but using the results from the filtering step. And this is also called the backward pass, since we are working from the last sample back to the first. Here we will focus on the filtering. In the linear dynamical system, we can do filtering one time step at a time. So let's take the example where we have some estimate of our latent distribution at time point t-1, and we are getting a new data observation y at time point t. We now want to estimate the corresponding latent distribution at time point t, given what we know about the latent at the previous time point and about the data. We already know that this would be, again, a Gaussian distribution, so we just need to find the mean and the covariance. And we will do this in three Gaussian transformations. First, we have prediction. Here we operate exclusively in the latent space, so using the prior. We simply project the latent distribution at the previous time point one time step forward using the transformation matrix F. Again, because the initial distribution is Gaussian and because we're simply adding Gaussian noise, we know this distribution will be Gaussian again, and we just need to find the mean and the covariance, which is straightforward. The mean will be F times the mean at the previous time point. And the same for the covariance, except that for the covariance, we need to add the noise covariance of the Gaussian noise that is added at time point t. Next, we want to compare this prior prediction to the measured data. So for this, we project our estimated latent distribution into the observed space through the observation matrix H. And this is the same linear projection that we just did in the latent space, but this time we do not move in time, but instead we stay at the same time point and we move from latent to observed space. This means we are making a guess about where we think the data should lie given the prior. Now we can compare our prediction to the actual measured data Y and compute kind of the difference that we have here between the mean of the projected distribution and Y. Given this comparison, we can derive a correction now back for our initial estimate of the latent distribution. This correction will change the mean and the covariance by a factor called the Kalman gain. The Kalman gain compares our certainty about the prior prediction in latent space to our certainty about our data measurements. Importantly, the Kalman gain depends inversely on the measurement noise R. If the measurement noise R is small, we have a large gain and heavily rely on the data. If R is large, so we're not very certain about our data, we think we have a lot of noise, we only make a small correction based on the data. Mostly we're going to rely on the prior in that case. With this correction, we derive at the filter estimate of our latent distribution at time point t. We can now continue propagating our distribution further along in time, step by step. This means that our final Kalman filter estimation of the later distribution at time point t will be used for the next time step. In different words, the posterior distribution at time point t will be the prior at time point t plus 1. You can now implement the projection and the correction step of the filtering in the notebook. And to compare, once you implemented the Kalman filter, running the Kalman filter will give us will give you an estimate of the latent distribution at every time point. And you can then look at the mean at every time point. So here in red, you should see something that is the kind of matches the latent trajectory since it's the mean of our estimation. So since we have produced the data ourselves, we can compare to the true latent trajectory and we see a close resemblance here, which means that the Kalman filter gives us a good estimate.